May 13th. I knew it. I knew it. I knew it. We got another swarm going.
Another one?
Look at all the bees in the air. So, I hope now you can hear the difference in tone in the buzz when they're swarming. And you can see the difference between traffic in and out of the hive and traffic all over the apiary. And it looks like they're headed for that branch up there, which is the one they landed on last year, or thereabouts. All right, May 13th, 2020. Another swarm came out. Kind of been watching the hives, expecting this. Just finished mowing the lawn. Come back through to check on them, and boom, they're blowing out. They're up in the cut. An actual swarm bucket that I did. I'm gonna dump them in the bucket. I got a hive drawing from a couple of foundations. A half a frame of honey on each edge. I got three other drawn comb over there. I'll drop them in there, and if they take to it, we'll drop the drawn comb machine on them. So, here we go. Ready? Set.
A bucket of bees.
Hopefully. You get clean in there with that. I think I'm gonna throw a cover on quick.
Oh, they're pouring out the entrance.
Yeah, they may do that for a bit. And I'm not sure I got the team yet, but they may still be up in the cluster. They're not happy with me. Let's see what they do. Still recording? Okay. Oh, they're all around me. What are you doing bumping us around? Not appreciated. I may end up having to cut this branch like last time and put it by the hive entrance. See that? Let me zoom in out a bit. Let's get you a close-up of the swarm cluster here. I'm looking for a queen, but it's awfully hard to pick a queen out in all that mass of bees. Anyway, I just thought I'd get a close-up.
So we got lots of fanning on the entrance. That's a good sign. It looks like they might be taken to this hive right away. That would be awesome. Yeah, they're fanning pretty good. We still got quite a cluster up on that branch.
I mean, maybe snag a quick of that again. I think I'll go up and do another bump into the bucket, pop the cover and dump them in again. probably got, what, two-thirds of the cluster, maybe three-quarters?
Yeah, three-quarters, I'd say.
They're probably just sticking to that because of the pheromone. But, of course, I didn't see the queen, so we can't be sure of that. But seeing all that fanning on the entrance is definitely a good thing.
Yeah, lots of good fanning both sides here. I'd say they're taken to the box.
Spreading those pheromones.
Boy, they sure are easier than... I better not say that.
You jinx yourself?
Yeah. Well, I was going to say, they seem, I'll say it this way, they seem to be easier taken to hives than Matt and Jan's bees yesterday. They just were stubborn, huh?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, hours later.
But they also, they didn't have drawn combs to put in. We had drawn combs in. And also, I put honey in here, so that's got to be a big thing for them. And I actually have some of the lemongrass oil that Jana gave me honey, but I don't know, I don't think we need it.
No.
We'll save that for swarm capture boxes. Speaking of which, we're going to get those up too. I don't know how we're going to get all that done this week.
Enter hive number 4 for the 2020 season. Beauteous. Square, just about square right there. The space between so we can work. I'm going to go up and do another bump into that bucket. Try and get the most of the rest of the cluster. Then I get back and drop the frames in, top on. I get a bee in my veil every time.
It's luck.
Yeah. I guess they love me, huh?
Your lucky bee.
Actually, I'm gonna put these guys. Well, no, I guess I did it a few days. Everybody. Whoever lingers can find their way. Diggity dog. That was easy, huh? Hope they stay. Yeah, look at them all fanning, dude. They're just fanning away. We got it. We got our spot. Come on in, we got our spot. Four hives, dude, four!
Yeah, they're back up there again. There is like two bees left on that branch though, so I doubt. They'll find their way.
Somebody was saying, one of the people I was watching, it might be Frederick Dunn. Might be the Honeystead.
Shout out to Frederick Dunn, the Honeystead, and a Canadian beekeeper's vlog. Little bits of Joe Honey, Black Bear Apiary. Anyway, one of those guys was saying that the pheromones linger on the branch even later on, and sometimes that's why swarms tend to go to the same branch. good. Spreading the pheromones. Doing their thing. Bucket's only got one bee left in it. Hey, hey, ladies, what's going on? You come out. Beautiful. Yeah, man. We actually have just enough room on this rack to fit a fifth hive if we get another swarm. Of course, all of those fold with three or four supers on. It's close to 1,000 pounds.
Coming.
Get it done. Let's see what we got here. Why don't you come around this side? You can come over my shoulder.
So you're not right in there.
Oh yeah, they're spreading right out to the frames. A little cluster there. This is part of a wasp nest.
Alright, let's just throw these frames in quick. Partially drawn comb.
Excuse me, ladies. Excuse me, ladies. Coming in. Out. I don't want to crush anybody.
Bomber will be upset with me if I crush anybody.
Look out, ladies. One more frame. One more frame.
Hope they just go in.
Multi-tool.
Nah. We'll just leave it for more. I don't want to disturb them too much anyway.
But I do
want to see this cupboard. I don't want to crush anybody. Come on, guys. Alright, here, we'll go this way.
Space in there. Come on, guys. Shift out of the way. Shift out of the way. I don't want to crush anybody if I don't have to. That's pretty good. They kind of moved out of the way. The only two bees got caught.
Good. Bomb will still be mad at me.
I can't help it, Bombs.
I can't help it.
These are crushed from before, from the fast catch. But...
Alright, they're framed up. They got a frame of honey on each edge, drawn comb to work. They're set with resources. I think that's a successful catch. I think that's it. We just caught another swarm. Awesome. Jeremy, thanks for filming.
No problem.
Just one quick clip of the branch after we moved the hive over, the swarm hive over. I did not go back and shake this a third time. They've scouted out the new location. You saw the bees fanning the pheromones out of the new hive location.
They're still coming back here and checking it out, but you can see this branch is pretty well cleared off. So they found the new hive on their own. Late afternoon, about 5 o'clock. Captured that swarm about probably 1 or 1:30, somewhere in there. Everybody's looking pretty well settled in. I'd call that success.